Hi and welcome back to Larand Gaming. I am Larand. Yes, we are in Fishing Simulator once again. And today we're gonna take a look at, Moby Wood. Nothing new to the most people. However, something is totally new though. And that's the amount of new players that I have seen dropping into this game lately. I think it's mostly because the Fishing Frontier is on its way. And when I check the achievements in the web browser, I see there is so many new players. And I see it in the chat, and they want to know how to get the Moby key, how to spawn Moby, how to battle Moby. They want to know everything about Moby. And I haven't done really a dedicated Moby Wood video, so maybe it's time to do that. And that's not actually all. This is the first video when I'm actually a content partner together with Cloud Entertainment. So, as you can see, if I type something now in the chat, it will look like this. Content partner. It's very nice. And as a step one in actually being able to spawn Moby Wood, I would highly recommend that you are level 25. And it's an epic ship. I'm not gonna be that distracted, I hope. But yeah, it's an epic ship. I like it. Yeah, so you need to be at least level 25. I would recommend that because that's when you unlock Shadow Isle. Otherwise, you will have like a barrier here. And most of the orcas is actually located on the other side of the barrier. But you might find orcas around closer to Watcher's Bay. And sometimes they do cross the border. So if you're at least above level 25, then you got this freedom to move around in the more dense orca territory. And the orcas is the only mob that can drop the Moby Wood key. So we need to fight those orcas. There's a pretty low drop rate. And it's gonna take a little bit longer in the beginning when you have a weaker spear. I'm gonna use my jaded crystal so I get also more loot from each orca, so hopefully it won't take as long when I'm gonna show you how this is done. So you kill the orcas and you're gonna go back and look for the key. The key itself is quite small, so many times you actually don't even notice when you pick it up because it's very very tiny, and it really won't show as good when you pick it up. So what I do is that I kill a lot of orcas, I go into the inventory to see if I actually have the key or not. That's at least the way I think is the easiest. And there is also a trick here that normally you can only get one key, and once you have one key in your inventory you cannot get another Moby Wood key. But however, if you decide to just kill a lot of orcas without picking up any loot, then there is a chance that there will be more keys dropping from orcas. And if you do this within, I think it's around 6 minutes. Let me check that. Hold on. And when I was supposed to check the timer, it actually spawned a key. Or it doesn't. It actually dropped a key from one of the orcas. And this is what the key looks like. As you can see, together with all the loot, this key is pretty small. So it's this one down here that is the key. But I'm not gonna pick up the loot to the left. So we're gonna see how long it takes until the loot despawns. So I will get at least now one key. And we will check how long it takes. Okay, so the loot despawned after around 7 minutes and 20 seconds. I don't really know if that's an exact time or if it's a little bit randomized, but that was when the loot at least despawned for me. So that's also the time you have to get as many Moby keys as possible if you aim to get more than just one key. Now I however have one Moby Wood key. Looks like this. It's a whale key. You can sell it, but that's not what I would recommend. But what you're gonna do after that is that you go down to the monster's burrow. You have this island over here, and on that island there is a cave, and in that cave I will just travel there instead and just show you instead of pointing on a map. So we are gonna go over to that island right now. So this is where you're gonna use the whale key to open this gate. And I'm actually gonna use a new feature here as well as a content partner. This is actually really cool, especially when you try to film some overviews. So by doing this, I'm gonna be able to just show you this island from a different perspective that most people are not used to see it. So this is the island where you spawn Moby Wood. Yeah, it's very nice. And let's go inside the cave. Let's open the gate. Now I've used the key, so it's a one-time use. So you're gonna need to find another key if you want to do this again. Inside here you have this trigger. It's a stone with some, I wouldn't say, some runic letters or something. But once you press this, the ground will start to rumble and shake, and you will spawn Moby. It will also start a timer, so once you have killed Moby Wood, it's on a 45 minutes cooldown, so you're not gonna be able to do this over and over and over again, which is, well, it makes sense, because otherwise you would be able to farm so much experience. And yeah, sure, there are people that jumps servers to another place where there isn't a cooldown active. And as long as Moby is out, this gate is gonna be open. So if Moby Wood for some reason despawns, you can always go back here and see if the gate has closed. Because if the gate is closed, it means that Moby Wood is gone and you have, well, lost the battle. Which is kind of sad, but that's the way it is. Maybe it will improve in Fishing Frontier, because yeah, they say that they rewrite all the code. So maybe that will also then include Moby Wood's behavior and will become less buggy. I don't know, but yeah, regardless, let's go to Moby Wood. Yeah, so Moby Wood, he spawns out here on the map between the S and the B. And here we can see the health, and he has a few different kinds of attacks. Usually he jumps up straight from underneath. Now, oh, okay, so here comes an attack. Jumps straight up. Oh, and I leveled up. That's nice. But this is the most common attack that he makes. If you get too close, he can eat you, which is, well, not so good. He has a spinning wave attack also. When he do that spinning wave attack, he normally just go in a straight direction up on the surface for a little while, and then afterwards he will start to spin, and he spins his body 360 degrees counterclockwise, and he makes waves that surrounds him. So if you're gonna try to avoid that attack when you're close, you're gonna need to follow that counterclockwise movement. Hopefully we will see this attack during this battle. And with a jaded spear, which has the highest damage in the game, it will require 100 hits to kill Moby Wood. So 100 hits is quite a lot. What we can do, just to give you an idea of how fast of a boat that you need to be able to evade these attacks, we can try a few different boats just to see what kind of minimum speed you should have, just to be sure that you can survive this kind of attack. Because if you have a slow boat, yeah, he will knock you high up in the air, he might eat you, he will most likely kill the boat and ruin your day, so you have to respawn. So we're gonna respawn and go to switch to something that is slower. So we're gonna go for a traditional speedboat 2. That's a speed of 90. So it's slower than the surfboard, and we're gonna see how we can get away with this one. So it's fully maximized. I don't really care about the health, because if you get hit once, you will get hit twice. So then it's no good speed. We need to know what kind of boat and what kind of speed we need to be able to survive. So here we are with a speedboat. Let's see, can we outrun Moby Wood with his attack from below. Yeah, this is no problem at all. So this boat, which is very popular early in the game, is really no problem. I have no difficulties in actually evading Moby Wood. Remember, it's fully maximized. But good to know, speed 90, no problems. Let's switch to something slower. And then we have a golden sailboat. This is also a very popular boat early in the game. It has the maximum speed of 70 when it's maximized. So we're gonna see if we can outrun Moby with a sailboat. This is gonna be interesting because I really don't have an idea. Because I've never been fighting Moby Wood in a sailboat. Where do I drive this boat? Yeah. Alright, so worth to mention here is that, as you can see, this boat extends pretty far back from the center position where I'm driving. Because Moby Wood is attacking me, not the boat actually. So that means that this extra distance might cause a problem, because Moby Wood might be striking the back of the boat instead. Oh, he's coming right now. Oh, that was close. But I did manage to get out from that attack. That's nice. Let's see if we can get one more of those attacks. Let's see. Yeah, he's coming right now. Yeah, so this doesn't seem to be a problem. That's very good. Especially since it's a very popular boat early in the game. It's close. It's very close. But perfectly doable. So we need to reset again and switch boat. So let's see. Let's find a sheep boat that has a speed of 60. So we have a speed boat. Yeah, why not? Speed boat. Speed 60. This is gonna be tough. However, it's a small boat, so maybe we can evade it because it's very short. We're gonna see how it performs. Okay, so here we have Moby again. This time, speed 60. This is gonna be tough. Yeah, short boat. Worked. I managed to get away from that attack. Fantastic. I had my doubts because I have never tried Moby Wood in this boat. It's very, very close, but still doable, which is awesome. But this is a very cheap boat. So even if you go around with this boat and just maximize the speed, that will of course cost you way more than the actual boat, I think. But if you do that, yeah, you can actually use this boat to fight Moby Wood. Okay, so enough with this boat. It works. Let's see if we can find something even slower. Let's reset once again. Okay, so this might be a little bit too slow. Speed 30. Rowboat. No. Fishing boat. Speed 50. I think if we're gonna keep the cost low, I think speed 50 is gonna be the only option that we have left, because a rowing boat, no, you're not gonna survive Moby Wood in a rowing boat. I'm not even gonna try it. So fishing boat, speed 50, still a small boat, but yeah, this is difficult. We're gonna equip it and we will see how this one performs. And this is also a problem, as we can see here. This boat extends even further out here on the back. So I think, here it comes. I think it's gonna strike the back. What? He didn't. I'm alive. All right, I didn't expect that. I was expecting a failure. All right, let's see if we can actually keep surviving the attacks. Looks promising, actually. I'm surprised. I didn't expect this result. Maybe I should try the rowing boat after all. All right, fully upgraded. Seems to be working. This is very cool. So some of the more expensive boats, they can't do this actually with this low speed. So it's a good result, especially if you're a newcomer to the game and haven't been able to purchase all the fancy extreme boats yet. Okay, so now he's gonna do this spinning attack. This is gonna be difficult though. I'm not gonna be able to. Oh, maybe I can. Ah, he knocked me. And the hit points, that was just horribly low. So yeah, I kind of got wrecked. Let's reset. Okay, so we only have one really, really slow boat left. That's a rowing boat. Yeah, rip. I'm gonna die. Oh my god. This is slow. It might be a cheap boat. This boat has actually some lights that you can turn on and off. The most expensive boat that costs 15 millions, there's no lights on it. So, it might be cheap, but it has lights. So that's nice. Okay, so here it comes. Can I possibly get out from this one? I don't know. I don't think so. Ah, oh, I couldn't. It was close though. It was remarkably close. but no. Rowing boat, regardless how much you put on upgrades, you're not gonna survive. And yeah, this is what it looks like to be eaten by Moby. Yeah, total fail, but as expected. You can fight Moby Wood from inside if you're being stuck in Moby Wood. But normally, if you get eaten by Moby Wood, I encourage everyone to reset, because on public servers where there's a lot of things going on, usually, or not usually, but it can happen that Moby Wood will despawn because of someone being inside Moby Wood. So if you're inside, just reset your character and start all over, because otherwise you miss out on the good experience, you miss out on the loot, no one will get anything. So yeah, if you get eaten, reset, all right? Yeah, and this is the most common boat that most high-level players uses when fighting Moby Wood. Speed 190. With this boat, there is rarely a problem to get away from Moby Wood. But yeah, sure, mistakes do happen. So even though you might have a fast and fancy boat, sometimes you fail. I do that as well. It's just normal. That's the way it is. But we're gonna finish off Moby Wood and see what we get. And there we go, Moby Wood down. And with this spear I will get 3 pieces of loot. Normally people get 2 if you have anything else but the jaded spear or the carrot spear. And we have a head, we have a tail, and we have Moby meat. And the Moby meat is worth 70 gems. No, 70. It's worth 50 gems. And it's something that you can return to Reagan, but that quest only gets available, I think it's at level 75. But I'm sure you can correct me if I'm wrong in the comments, but I think it's level 75. So yeah, that's a Moby battle. In any case, that was all I had for you today. If you do have any questions and comments about this, please put them below. Like this video if you would like to see more content from Fishing Simulator and Fishing Frontier. Please subscribe. Yeah, please do. And yeah, you know what? Have a nice day. Oh yeah, just one more thing before I end this. If you do get the whale tooth, looks like this, and haven't done the quest over at Faroe Dunes, you can save it, because that's a quest item. It's good to know. I sold it myself the first time I got it, and then I got to Faroe Dunes, and then I had to try to get this one again, and it can take a while before you actually get the tooth. But this is something that might change in the remaster, so the quest will no longer be available, because they are redoing a few things over at Faroe Dunes. I know that. But yeah, that was all. Bye everyone.